Luckily, I had a chance to do nephrology. I got second rank in nephrology, but still, as I was so much interested in critical care, I don't want to, because there are so many patients dying out of so many illnesses where there is no specialty to take care of that. For example, you take cardiology, there are cardiologists, outnumbered cardiologists are there. Like Vellore has 12 cardiologists, nephrology, so many nephrologists are there. So then I thought this branch where nobody is there in the next 3-4 districts. So I thought, let me pursue this. So I left nephrology. I initially joined and then left it and then joined critical care. So with Amma's blessings, I was able to manage my course, and then I came back to the same hospital. Mainly the goal was, so it's been almost 6 years. Now after 6 years, when I came back, like I've been here for the past 2 years now, this time. So I can see the number of patients coming to this hospital has increased so tremendously. The reasons I would say probably the trust towards this hospital. Second thing is the quality of the treatment is like so nice, this is what I personally feel. And the care given to them is like, the patients themselves feel the care given to them is very satisfactory. So they keep coming to this hospital, the word of mouth increases, they go tell to the friends and relatives. So that's why the number of patients also has increased a lot. So reason for joining the same hospital, despite getting all the options to go to Australia and Singapore and other countries, but still we left out all those options and joined this hospital. Reason, I see it personally, this is my personal view. Patients who have lots of money in India, they go to tertiary centers, like centers in Chennai and centers in Bangalore and other tertiary center hospitals, like very big hi-fi posh hospitals. They have lots of money, they go spend for the treatment to those, you know, in those hospitals where they get good quality treatment also, because they have lots of American board degree holders working in those hospitals. They get that six figure salary and things like that. So those kind of doctors are pooled only there in that hi-fi tertiary Chennai and Bangalore, that's like city centers hospitals. So the patients reach their hospital finally who have money. So they get that quality treatment. So which means, like, if you have money, lots of money, you get the quality treatment. And it is very difficult for a middle class or a lower middle class or somebody who is below poverty line to afford that hi-fi quality treatment. So unfortunately, they end up going to some primary health centers or secondary centers in a small town like Vellore. There are many other small towns like this in Tamil Nadu and India for the matter. So finally, they end up going to small town hospitals where they get cheaper treatment, but the quality of the treatment is also not that great. This is what is happening in many other small towns. I'm not saying like in all the small town hospitals, but many other small town hospitals, because the qualified, highly educated doctors don't stay there in small towns. They all want to go to bigger cities and hi-fi countries and Australia's and all those developed countries, Canada and US and everywhere. So I saw there was a big gap between the, you know, like, you have money, you get high-fi quality treatment in bigger hospitals. You don't have money, you get substandard treatment in the secondary and the primary hospitals. So I thought, why can't we bridge this gap? Why can't we get the high-fi quality treatment at the cheaper price? And the high-fi quality treatment which is available there in the bigger cities and bigger countries, why can't we bring all this high-fi treatment in the smaller, small town hospitals like we have it in Vellore? And why can't we get that high-fi quality doctors coming and working in this hospital and give the same quality treatment at cheaper price? So this is what was my motto initially when I started, and this is what I feel probably all my colleagues are also, you know, feeling about. That's what we always used to discuss whenever we have this doctors meeting here in this hospital. So that's why I started working back in the same hospital. So when I joined by 2011, I would say, this hospital was not having a medical ICU at all. There wasn't any ICU. Basically, I deal with critical care patients, all those terminally ill patients, all those very sick patients, sick patients again into cardiac illnesses, sick patients again into renal illnesses, whatever it is, or multi-organ dysfunction. So when I joined, that was the time when we started having medical ICU for this hospital. Till then, there was no medical ICU as such. So we started having 4 beds initially. Then when I rejoined 2-3 years back, after all those critical care training, we started with 15 bed ICU. Now we have 15 bed ICU. We have upgraded ourselves to step down ICU which has 6 beds, then surgical ICU which has another 6 more beds, neuro ICU with 5 beds, and all those patients, all those beds are fully occupied, and still we are like running shortage of beds. So here the problem with Vellore district is, here the medical care is so excellent, but the number of beds for the population which is out there is like very less. For the next 3-4 districts, there is no other hospital apart from Sri Narayani Hospital and the Christian Medical College, which is like 6 kilometers from here. So, and CMC also has only 25 ICU beds with them for the population, which is like so many hundred and millions of population out there, but still only 25 ICU beds is really not sufficient at all. So that's why I didn't join CMC also, because I know there are, if I'm not going to work in CMC or in tertiary centers or in other developed countries, some other brainy is also going to work, who's definitely there to replace me. So anyways, those patients are going to get quality treatment. So I thought I should go to a place where nobody else is there, where patient needs those care, where nobody is willing to go. So that's why these are the reasons why I joined back this hospital actually. So so CMC has only 25 ICU beds. So finally, invariably, all those patients referred from other 3-4 districts, they land up in CMC or to Narayani, and many times the lack of beds, shortage of beds, so they have been referred to go to some other hospitals. So finally they like come here, and luckily this hospital is there. If not, these patients have to travel 3 hours from here to Chennai. Chennai is the nearest tertiary center and is the 4th metropolitan city in India. So like they have to go to Chennai with on road 3 hours of journey with all this medical problems. Most of the times they may not make up reaching those hospitals. They die on the way. So it's like very pathetic. So that's why we are morally we are so responsible for them, and we can't even think of Saturdays and Sundays or weekends or festival offs or Christmas or New Year or anything. I many times I don't even remember what day it is, because every day is very same for me. There's no Sundays for me. There's no, I could remember working on December 31st night in the hospital. 12 o'clock I was putting a patient on ventilator. So I could see this need was so much for these patients over here. I'll just get this. So I could see the need of this specialty was so much. We really forget our, it's not sacrifice, I would say. It is like we happily do it for the patient's sake. So we sacrifice all those, there's no fixed working hours for us. Hospital says 8 hours is enough. If you work for 8 hours, is enough. But we end up working for 10 hours and 12 hours happily. That's the thing. Happily, we do it from our heart, because we know patient already got referred from CMC saying no beds available there. And in case if I am referring the patient from this hospital to Chennai hospital saying that already my duty time is over, already it's like 14 hours, already it is like 16 hours, I cannot work more than this, then that patient may not even reach those hospitals in Chennai. So it's like you're morally responsible for the patient. There's no other option. You really have to say, if you're not doing it, the patient will definitely like. So this is the real scenario. It is not exaggeration or anything. This is a real scenario. So many times I used to start from the hospital at 8 o'clock in the night, at night, though my duty finishes at 5 p.m. But still, it sometimes used to be like 7:30 and 8. By then, when I was about to start, I used to have a patient in ambulance coming in and saying the patient is very sick, we need to receive the patient. So I really cannot, we really cannot say no to them. So the morally we are so responsible. That's the duty. That's why we are here, to do this mainly. So I used to grab a bread there in the ICU, sit there, and then, receive the patient, somehow stabilize and, explain to the relatives, make the relatives comfortable, do all this work and go back to the home at 11 o'clock. And you sleep for, half sleep and half dream, something like that, half wake, half sleep. Because you'll be getting calls about the patient's status, though there are other doctors to take care of, but all the other doctors are not well trained as like the seniors, the junior doctors needs more training. So they need lots of guidance. So you really have to sacrifice sleep and keep telling them on the phone also. So we do lots of video, WhatsApp video calls, video ICU rounds we used to do. So and morning you wake up at 5:45 and refresh and come back here at 7 o'clock. And the once again the day routine starts from 7 to the, you know, like endless. And this goes on for 24/7. And I really don't remember when was my birthday. For example, on Jan 8th, it was my birthday. I really could not even remember the day it was my birthday. And I came to the OPD after I finished my rounds. I came to the OPD. I was busy seeing the patients, and my colleagues brought cake into the OPD. Then I remembered, okay, it is my birthday. I couldn't even remember. It was like that busy. I couldn't even see my Facebook. Nowadays, Facebook at least reminds us, it's your birthday, this is your days and all. So it's something like this. Probably you can understand. So it's not just, I would not say it as a sacrifice at all. It is like we do it wholeheartedly. So it is nothing sacrifice. You don't lose anything. Many people used to, even my parents used to wonder, why do you want to stay back? Why do you want to like struggle 24/7? Why do you want to boil your blood like this? What are you going to do with all these things? You're not even making money. You're not even having a Porsche car. You don't have like excellent hotels here in Vellore. My parents used to say like, okay, like our generation suffered in a small town like this, but why do you want to suffer after all this, you know, 6 degrees? Why do you want to suffer in small town? But this is our choice. This is like, we really want to do it. We stay back. So there's no exaggeration. Probably you would have seen Vellore. It's very difficult to stay in a small town like this, actually. So we have done our, you know, studies from, I did my UG undergraduates and postgraduates from metropolitan cities, and I have been working in Singapore before joining this hospital. By 2011, I was working in Singapore, Changi General Hospital. Despite seeing all those hi-fi, world-class hospital centers, and I've been to Europe to write this exam. So despite seeing all this, we're not attracted to those things at all. Because on back of the mind, the poor patients who deserve this care is what, you know, really bothers them at the end of the day. So satisfying them is more important is what I feel personally. So it is, I wouldn't say this is a sacrifice, sacrificing our personal things and all, because it is not a sacrifice. It is really your duty to serve them. If you really could, why can't you just do this to the, you know, patient who needs this? So we don't feel it as a sacrifice at all. We happily do it. At the end of the day, patient has to go back home. We have to give the patients back to the family so that the family, you know, gets a breadwinner back to them. Their, you know, close mother or daughter coming back to the family is like giving the whole happiness to the family back. So it's like you really cannot compare the happiness of that with the traveling in a Porsche car in a country like Canada or Australia. I mean, after having born here, I think we should really help these people who really deserve it, who really want those medical treatment, care, love and affection, everything, I would say. So luckily our hospital got upgraded to the government health scheme from category 4 to category 1 on the same day. So we just got the mail from the director saying that. So it's another boost to this hospital. This recognition is all because all the doctors are really working around the clock. It's not just me. Whatever I said about me is not just me. This is the same motto with most of the doctors in this hospital. Because most of the doctors have many qualifications, despite having all the opportunities to go abroad, they stay back and they really work for the patients, for the betterment of the patients. And I hope this continues, and in future we'll be staying here for sure. There's no doubt in that. Even now I've been trying to do my observership in other countries and come back and work here, because I really want to implement those unreachable HIFA treatment. Unreachable to this poor population, I'm saying. Unreachable treatment, I should make that, you know, reach this population who really needs it. So this is all. Many times I used to, really feel worried about the patients. I used to somehow find difficulty sleeping. The patient is sick out there and the family is waiting outside. And they'll be like, literally, they'll be like very poor. Very poor. They probably would be making 200 bucks per day, 200 rupees is like $3 Canadian dollars per day. That's what their income is. And your responsibility on that patient is like, see, if something goes wrong with the patient or if the patient dies, nobody is going to sue you to the court. You're not medically liable at all. Medical legally, nobody is going to question you, because our country is not, they don't have that exposure for the medical legal things at all. But despite all this, it's not that legal fear which we are working. It's like, I mean, we don't used to get sleep till that patient goes back home. It's like, okay, the relative is waiting outside and patient is on the ventilator with all this infusions, medications going on. So somehow I should give the patient back to the family. So with whatever the knowledge which we have acquired, maybe that is not enough. Maybe I should ask my friend. Maybe I should call my colleague who is there and who is working in New York Hospital in the US. So I used to call them, I used to mail them, because that's when the it's day for them in US. So by night, 11 o'clock, I used to be like sitting and chatting with them on the mail and asking, so and so, myasthenia gravis patient is there on the ventilator. Is the treatment perfect for them? Should I need to do something else? Is there anything new which has come over there which is not still implemented here in India? So I used to discuss with them, and even after discussions, I used to go to bed, but still, you know, like call every now and then, find out what happened, is it okay. So this is how our life is, and we really enjoy it. My friends who is in other profession used to see and say, I mean, that's why we don't want to become doctors, because you doctors really suffer a lot. But it is not suffering, it is like, we happily do it. This has become our routine. If I'm not working, if I'm on a leave and sitting at home, that's the day when I get depressed. Seriously, I'm not exaggerating. Seriously, I'm saying, for last year, 26 leaves which was given to us, I don't utilize. If you're not utilizing within that academic year, it would get nullified, it would get wasted. But I didn't even bother about it, because the day when I'm coming to the hospital is the thing which gives me pleasure. So if I'm sitting there at home, it gives me depression. Anyway, so this is me, this is Jayaprakash.